I explain, let me share with you some example. If I was working on some software project, so we have a team. In that team, obviously every person have different role. Some people they are working on databases, some people they are working on graphic designers, some people they are working on user interface. So all these people are working in different environment, and maybe they are connecting to each other through virtually or maybe online. But still, they need to coordinate very efficiently, because if they are not doing coordinated activities, it means that they are wasting resources and time. And maybe at end of the day, we are heading to nowhere. We cannot develop any product if our team members are not associated or coordinated to each other very efficiently. So what we need to do, this coordination is associated with the radical innovations. So when you are doing with the radical innovations, obviously the ideas need to be exchanged and the roles need to be defined very clearly. And that's why the people working on, especially the team members working on some radical innovative project, they need to communicate or they need to coordinate very efficiently. That is the parameter or association. Remember, when you are dealing with this team, especially cross-functional team, you will learn something new from your friends, maybe because of their area of expertise is entirely different than yours. And obviously you have different area of expertise, but while working together, you can reinvestigate or reassure your skills also. You can try to learn some cross-functional knowledge from others and try to reinterpretation of your competencies. Maybe during the work you realize that you need to go beyond what is your conventional skill. So at that time you must need to do that. So in any team, the coordination will give us this benefit. We can learn some part of the other work also because of the coordination. We are working together, and maybe through this we are also enhancing our own skills. So that is very important part. Now the third thing is, basically you need to generate your ability to learn from your basic knowledge. Radical innovations are something you are developing a new product to the market that is not available, that is not innovative in terms of incremental innovation. This is radical innovation. In the radical innovation, mostly the concept and the product, they are new to the market. But all new products will not come from the new ideas. You have the knowledge. You have your existing knowledge about the product. For example, let me give you one example of Grab. The Grab is an application like Uber, and many other applications are there now. Nowadays, we are using them. We are using these extensively. Is the idea new? What do you think? Is this a new idea? It is not, because the need for the traveling is always there. But the people who thought about it, they think differently. They use their existing knowledge or understanding about some particular problem, allow them to ability to innovate and develop a new product. So whenever you have knowledge, you have understanding on some particular product you can produce, or some particular problems you can provide solution, and that solution would be the radical product. WhatsApp, Facebook, all these social media, these all are basically these type of innovative products. When we have knowledge, we know that we need to communicate each other, right? But still we don't think, why not we create some different products? So use your existing knowledge on all particular areas, maybe for this particular problems, and think to solve that problem. That would be your radical product. When you are trying to think to solution of any particular problem, that will allow you to reinvestigate your resources and coordinate with others to develop some very, very good product to the market. So that is the greater inter-functional coordination, and that will be associated with these three major parameters. Let's move. Now let me quickly show you how this new product development process it works and what are the basic components of performance in cross-functional teams. So let's see innovativeness, rather than it is incremental or it is radical innovation. This innovativeness is never directly positively related with product quality. It is inverse, negatively related, not positively. So that's why I show this innovativeness is negatively related with product quality. Now this is strange. We think that okay, we develop something new, it should be very good and very quality product. No, when we improve products or we develop new products, especially the radical innovation, remember in this radical innovation the improvements need to be done later on. The first thing, you will develop solution, and solution will come with so many bugs, so many problems, so many issues. So that's why every software, every product have its own versions. The first they develop and then they improve. So first time when the product was developed, the quality was poor. So there is a negative relationship between innovativeness and the product quality. You cannot say at the same time you have innovated the product and provided high quality products. No. When you added new feature, they need to be tested and they need to be improved over the years. So that's why innovativeness is directly, inversely, related with product quality. But remember, later on we can make innovation. So let us see the scenario of innovativeness only. So innovativeness is basically the function of two major elements. Either your customers are going to influence you, you need to improve your product. I gave you examples of many customer feedback. We have customer feedback mechanisms. If any company, especially the high-tech product, if they don't have this customer feedback mechanism, they cannot innovate. Innovation comes from customers' input. So that's why the customer's input is the major element that influences your innovativeness, innovative process. And the second one, your team identity. Either your team is good enough. Let me give you one example. The Google, one of the best innovative organization in the world. I gave you one example in the class. They have this Google Duplex, the new software, AI, the higher level of AI. But if you see Google, anybody is working in the Google organization, they will proudly say, okay, I'm part of this Google and I'm part of this particular project, Google Duplex. This will give them honor and feeling. This feeling will allow them to be motivatedly work for innovative products, think new ideas. So that is how innovativeness is being influenced. The first one, customer influence, and the second one, your team also is a major component of influencing your innovativeness. Next, this innovativeness, obviously it needs to be related with risk-taking ability. I explained earlier, if you do innovative products, it means that you are taking risk. And if you are taking risk, it means that maybe your idea, or maybe when you go into the design stage, or maybe in the practical stage, and many products are there, they fail in the market. So the failure, the chances of failure are there. That's why it's a risk. The risk that people will accept your product or not, especially in the case of radical innovation, because in incremental innovation you already have your customers locked with you, so you are just sending them out or giving them new option in the similar product. So incremental innovation may be not too much risky, but when it comes to radical innovation, sometimes it is not acceptable by the society and the people. I gave you example of holography. If you remember, holography was invented in 1916, and the Ford company, they used their board for holographic image. But at that time, people were not so much convinced. And then later on, now you can see that holography is your future. And similarly, I gave you example of this Concorde plane. the transportation through this plane was started in 1965, but the first flight was crashed, and then later on they suspended their operations and now they started again. So many products, radical innovations, they are traditionally linked with higher levels of risk-taking ability. Remember, those firms who take risk, their return is higher. Those they don't take risk, their return may be not so higher. So encouragement for taking risk in your team members is very important. Cross-functional team should be able to take some degree of risk. I explained to you, remember, if in the previous class, not all members or not all cost you can take risk. No, if you want to take risk, obviously you need to define some parameter to what degree you can take risk. Not you can spend all money for R&D in one project and getting nothing, because the firms, obviously high-tech companies, they are looking for profit. And if you are disturbing that balance of equation, it would be difficult for any organization to survive. So all cross-functional team, they need to decide what degree of risk-taking ability they can have, and then they can allocate budget accordingly. So that is the first thing also related to your innovativeness. So higher levels of risk-taking will give you positive innovative results. So that's why this is positively related. Then secondly, monitored by the senior manager. That is very important. At all level of product development process, cross-functional team need to be monitored by the top management. So at least they can interact and they can update the progress of their product to their senior managers. And at the time when the product should be in the final stage, they should be ready for taking it to the market and all the prototypes and everything. So remember, top management monitoring in terms of cross-functional team is very important. So this is the scenario of innovativeness. I explained to you, this innovativeness is negatively related with product quality. And remember, this product quality is mainly the function of two things. The first, quality orientation. I explained earlier, you can learn from the customer experience or you can predict their future demands. So in both cases, you are learning from the market and from the customer. So quality orientation means from where you learn the quality. It is basically, quality is always customer oriented function. So whenever you are dealing with the quality orientation, you need to understand what are the steps required to maintain the product quality and what is the mechanism to get that input. So I explained in the past class, you have two mechanisms. Either you take input from the customer or you can predict their future demand. And second, information integration, very important. Information you collected, but how this information is integrated into your class cross-functional team, that is important. It should be disseminated to all responsible persons and clearly mention what is their role. If information is not integrated into your cross-functional team mechanism, it is very difficult for team members to work alone. So that's why that is another important factor. Okay, let me just explain to you. This is the last slide, as I mentioned in all my classes. This is my last slide. So last few slides are now. So let's see what are the parameters or determinants whether cross-functional team, they work efficiently or not. So to do that, you need to do communication upward, horizontal, and all cross-functional team, between the group team, you need to focus on the communication. Sharing of information, sharing of knowledge, new ideas, and also what is happening into the market and into the team members, that need to be clearly addressed and communicated. Then the second one is team orientation. How this team is working, what is their mechanism, and how they are learning, that is very important factor. So when you understand team orientation, the steps are required to learn within the team, to work together, this need to be very much affiliated, or we need to be understandable for the team member. So make it clear, communicate efficiently, and then try to learn from the team mechanism, learning within the team, and team orientation is important factor. And the final one is the reward system. Obviously, innovativeness, the people, they are spending their level of expertise, their time, their energies to this R&D project. So it is obvious it should be related with some kind of reward system. So reward system at all level, it should be very important. Maybe you can give them, we call it tangible or non-tangible reward, but it should be related with the successful completion of any project or any innovative idea. So that is determinants of effective team interactions. So you communicate efficiently, you do team orientation and learn from each other, and the team mechanism should be very clear, and then the reward should be established very clearly with the level of innovativeness for each person. Okay, so let me just conclude in 2 minutes today's lecture. We discuss about the different mechanism of cross-functional team. We try to understand at first level. So understanding of cross-functional team was basically what are the cross-functional team and why we use them. That is what I cleared in this class. And then we discuss on the new product development and cross-functional team mechanism. So how it is important for cross-functional teams to work together in the form of team successfully complete innovative products. Okay, and then finally I discuss the basic determinants of team interaction between the team members for successful innovative products or innovative process. So that is what we learn today. And finally, remember, any question you can post me, you can share, and you can like, and you can comment on this video. So from my side, this is a complete presentation or complete. I will try to upload this on your ULearn also. So that's all for first part of this lecture, chapter 4. I'll try to send you another video tomorrow. So try to complete this and try to ensure that you have understand and you have read all the material, relevant material I have already provided you on ULearn. So that is it. Thank you very much and stay safe. Help your friend and take care of your family and friends. We'll see you tomorrow, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.